Let's finish our discussion of simple QR algorithms by revisiting what the expense here actually is. We probably would want to use a householder-based QR factorization right here. Okay, so that would mean that this step would cost 4/3 m cubed, but remember that we don't explicitly form Q then. We end up with the householder vectors with which we can recreate what the action of Q is. Okay. We then want to do R times Q, and there's probably some way of taking advantage of the fact that we have Q as individual householder transformations. And you know that in the end, the resulting matrix is again Hermitian. So you should be able to take advantage of some of the symmetry that comes in, or maybe not. But actually, it's really hard to analyze. So let's just cheat. And let's say this is some big O of m cubed, right? Some constant times m cubed, roughly speaking. And then we should be able to carefully analyze what the cost of applying the householder transforms from the right to a matrix V is. But let's be sloppy there too. If we're sloppy here, we might as well be sloppy there. So we'll just say, let's order M cubed as well. Okay? The point we're trying to make with all of this is that each iteration takes order m cubed computations. Now, it is the case that as we deflate, our problem becomes smaller and smaller and smaller. But what that really means is that we have some kind of sum from j equals 0 to m minus 1 of something that's order m cubed, and that is order m to the fourth. Order m to the fourth is unacceptably expensive. So no matter what the details of these two parts are, as a matter of fact, if these two parts were free, the fact that this is 4/3 m cubed would still make this algorithm unacceptably expensive. What we're going to see next is that there is a pre-processing step that we can apply to our original matrix A that transforms matrix A into a tridiagonal matrix that has the same eigenvalues and from which the eigenvectors of the original matrix can be recovered. When we do that, if we're only interested in computing the diagonal matrix A and not interested in accumulating the eigenvectors, then each iteration of the algorithm becomes order m time. And if we do accumulate the eigenvectors, then each iteration becomes order m squared time. And then all of a sudden we end up with a practical algorithm. Now, on top of that, we can cast all of our computations to only involve unitary matrices. So then we get all the benefit of numerical stability as well.